She crawled and fumbled in the dark. Her knees got dirty, and she scratched herself so that there were red streaks on her skin, and she thought that she would get stuck and starve to death. But after a while, she came up to another door that was half the size of the previous one.
I definitely can't get through that, even if the key fits.
Nonetheless, she put the key in the lock, and the door did indeed open. But however hard she tried, her shoulders were too wide, and she could only stick her head through. Inside the door, she could see a garden with grass and flowers, and gooseberry bushes, and apple trees with big red apples that looked delicious. Alice hadn't eaten for hours after all, and was hungry. How can I get in there? She thought anxiously, noticing that she was stuck in the door opening. Now I can't either go forwards or backwards. If I could just become smaller somehow, then I could get out on the other side. But how would that work? Certainly some pretty extraordinary things had happened here in Wonderland, but that she should suddenly become small enough to fit through the door, it was hardly likely to be possible. She yearned to get out into the garden with the lush green grass and all the fruit trees and bushes, where the sun shone on the golden yellow apples and dark red raspberries and the shimmering blue plums. But how could she get there? Then suddenly, she caught sight of a little bottle that was hidden behind a rhubarb leaf. Its cork protruded, just close to Alice. What kind of a little bottle is that? Maybe I can reach it, she thought, squeezing her arm out and stretching for the bottle that had a label on it saying, "Drink me." You can't just drink something without knowing what it is. What if it's poison or some kind of sleeping potion? I might fall asleep and lie here and eventually starve to death. These thoughts buzzed around Alice's head like fireflies, and her throat was all dry, so she had no choice, since she didn't want to either die of thirst or hunger.